just about everybody enjoys wildflowers. They're so simple, and yet so beautiful. In a world full of noise and confusion, they offer peace, serenity, and solace. One of the best places to learn about wildflowers and other native plants is the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center in Austin.
The Wildflower Center is really about native plants. Our stated mission is to educate people about the environmental necessity, the economic value, and the natural beauty of native plants.
Water conservation is a major issue that faces all of us. The Wildflower Center conducts numerous programs where people can learn management techniques and how to use native plants to save water. The results of these practices are evident all over the grounds. Walking the numerous trails is a great way to see the benefits of this kind of conservation. It's also a great place to simply enjoy the outdoors. Another popular site shows how you can utilize native plants around your home.
This area is called the Theme Gardens. This is where we show different types of demonstrations of how to arrange plants in somewhat of a formal setting.
There are themes for almost every interest. Want to keep deer out of your garden? There are plants for that. Attracting songbirds is easy when you select the proper native plants. If you want to show the red, white, and blue, why not grow it and save water at the same time? Plants in the theme garden are labeled to educate visitors about the possibilities of using native plants.
That gives them several choices. They have the opportunity to come out here and see all the different varieties of plants that we have and to use those to their liking. Native plants don't require us using pesticides and fertilizers that could damage the environment. And economically speaking, it saves water, time, maintenance. The other thing is it's educational. It provides education to children as well as adults on using these types of plant materials as landscape in the home and in commercial areas.
The Wildflower Center is not only a source of inspiration, it's also a source of plants.
We have two gardening festivals each year. We have one in the spring and one in the fall. And we have lots of education-related activities aimed at the local Central Texas audience, especially people that maybe just moved here from another place and don't know about our native plants, people that just bought a house and are looking for ideas. We have many extremely knowledgeable volunteers. We have people throughout the horticulture industry that come and help us that day of the festival.
You know, kill it lightly, put the seeds down, pack it a little bit, put some water as fine as you can. Let good Lord take over.
All righty?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So the idea is that people can come and get the information they need and the resources they need to go home and actually plant a native landscape.
The plants are propagated and grown here on the grounds. It gets quite busy those times of years because we're preparing and providing quite a production of plants. We have approximately about 170 different species that are available. You're sure to get a nice variety of native plants.
About a third of our native plants are threatened or endangered. Planting native species is a way to invest in the future of our natural heritage. It's a way to demonstrate our love for the natural world and teach our children a valuable lesson.
We are interested in transforming the way people think about plants so that they can gain a better knowledge and understanding of their ecological heritage, especially here in Central Texas. We run a large number of educational programs, everything from public outreach to school group visits. We have conferences and seminars on special topics such as oak wilt and then juniper control.
You can light this and you send a head fire, it runs into that.
There's a couple of different approaches you can take. One of the approaches recommended by our landscape restoration program is to implement controlled burns to encourage the growth of grasses and wildflowers.
This is a little wind meter. Works pretty well out in the field. You know, you think it's just a little toy, but it actually works pretty well. On the left side, it has a low scale that goes from about 2 miles per hour up to 10. And if you've got winds like we do today, that side of the scale is okay. And be sure and watch it if it tries to come across. Now just imagine if you had to walk 2 miles standing bent over like that. Hold up. Anytime you see anything that's different from what it was doing, like it's going that way, stop, you know, and let it do what it's gonna do. And more than likely, it's gonna come back this way here in a second. If you wanna just back him up after he wets it, and just kinda stir it up a little.
All right.
When done correctly, prescribed burns can be focused precisely where you need them to help bring back a diversity of plants. The Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center has so many dimensions. It's a place to learn, a place to look, a place to connect.
The Wildflower Center is a place about place. It's a place that demonstrates the biological richness and the botanical diversity of the Texas Hill Country. Everything you see here is native to this part of the world. And the idea is that every place is rich and beautiful, including this place. And so we want you to come here and see what we've done just using the native plants of the Texas Hill Country. And then, of course, our real encouragement is just to get out in nature and look around you and look at it deeply and look at the patterns in nature and how they work. And we encourage people to try to bring those patterns into their own lives and in their own communities.